What, your dad couldn't wait around? You could have waited in the barn. No, but hey, we gotta see your grandmother before she goes down for the night. Smooth sailing from here on, right, Junior?
You got any flat fix? My dad uses flat fix. He's sprayed on, drive away. Bet you wish you got some of that flat fix, huh, Uncle Bobby?
Yeah, wish you had, and no, I don't. Say, you won't come out here and learn how to do this?
I don't think my dad would want me to.
Look, I don't know how much your dad had mentioned to you about your grandmother, but she might not be the way you remember her. It's been a tough year. It's important that we spend time together as a family. And
Uncle Bobby.
Looks like bears have discovered fire.
If a tree falls in the forest and no one is there to hear it, does it make a sound? It does if a bear sets it on fire. Reports of torch-wielding bears continue to pour in from rural areas. And while the reports of the bears' pyrotechnics remain unsubstantiated, local experts agree we are experiencing a dramatic spike in unpermitted campfire. Leaving this reporter to ask, as Smokey lost his way.
We were talking, we were thinking, you know, full-time care.
Full-time care.
Are you sure? I mean, she seems pretty lively to me this morning.
I'm not deaf. Don't talk about me like I'm not here.
Well, then listen to the nurses, Mama.
Don't bother to come tomorrow. I already have one hand on the gate. I won't have long to linger here.
Lois?
The recent migration of bears may have been caused by the appearance of so-called newberries, an invasive species of fruit that act as nourishment for the large omnivore.
Come on, Junior, it's time to go.
Unbearable flavor to human taste buds. Regardless of the reason, locals question if we're weathering a temporary phenomenon or if these burning beasts are here to stay.
Junior? Junior! Junior, what in the world are you doing?
Well, I mean, it seemed like a neighborly thing to do.
Neighborly? Look, they're just stupid animals. Go back to your house, Junior. Now!
All right, you got down here that I gotta pay for a handrail.
Mm-hmm.
My mother broke a handrail.
Yep.
How did my mother break a handrail in a wheelchair?
What you got there, Junior?
I found these berries on a weird bush in Uncle Bobby's.
And you want $400 for that window.
Mmm. Just the sort of things bears would like.
Gosh almighty. How are we doing, Mom?
Oh, just marvelous. I have drove a million miles, and I'm ready to go over the other shore. I don't have long to linger here.
Big bear in the forest park, looking for a tourist to tear apart and bring back home to his family and friends. Little Peter Brown.
How could Grim have drove a million miles?
Have driven? I don't know. Old people tend to exaggerate. Hello. Speaking.
I've got some bad news for you. Your mother's gone.
I was just there.
I'm really sorry.
Well, I guess we all knew this day was coming.
You misunderstood me. She's not dead. Your mother has escaped.
Escaped?
That's not possible.
We're fairly confident.
How can you?
We also called the sheriff's office.
Your grandmother's gone. Look. I'm gonna come down. Junior! Stop! Junior, you listen to me. I'm your temporary legal guardian. Man, what is it with you and running? You're killing me.
She's with the bears.
Who? Stop.
What?
Stop! Just slowly back away.
You gotta trust me.
We have to get going.
Bobby.
Mm. You all right?
Yeah.
Anybody hurt? You gave us quite a scare. Found her. What, is she hard of hearing? Come on, lady, we gotta go.
Hey, she's not deaf.
Four to base. We're gonna be heading out of here in about 10. Over. You guys. You know, you're lucky that we aren't pulling three bodies out of there.
You are lucky.
Excuse me.
Oh. You are. I'm not supposed to use you and you are in the same sentence.
And you're his father?
No, ma'am. His uncle.
Oh. Well, you can tell his parents they can come down to the station to pick him up.
Well, but I can...
No, I'm sure you understand. It would be irresponsible for us to leave him with you.
It's all right, son.
All right. Time to go.
Can't eat them.
Unless you're a bear.
Okay, Leo, nod if you can hear me. I know you may feel a little hazy at the moment, but if you can just try to relax your mind.
I feel like I'm dreaming.
That's okay. It's all part of stage one. In order to access the full extent of your long-term memory, you've had to reduce the effectiveness of your short-term, so it's perfectly natural to feel confused about your surroundings. The mind is easily distracted. We don't want you to lose focus whilst you're under, or you could be displaced.
I don't understand.
Well, there is a slight risk with cerebral recollection of this kind, where the patients can go off the grid. But you've come to the best place, and you can trust me. It's a complex process to explain. Can you remember my name?
Doctor.
Michelle. Dr. Michelle, that's right. Can you remember how you got to the facility today? Did you drive? Can you drive? Do you remember why you came here today?
No.
It's okay.
No, I don't remember.
Don't worry, you're safe. It just shows the process is working. Now, can you remember my name? Good. I think we're ready. First, we need to get a baseline for your memory track. Think of it as a word association game. We just need to see which direction your mind chooses to take. It'll help us calibrate the machine.
Okay.
Tree.
Birch.
Good. Metal.
Iron.
Animal. Don't force it. There is no right or wrong answer. Just say what's on your mind.
Fish.
Fish. Okay, good. Family.
Son.
Nature.
Mother.
That's great, Leo. Now I want you to keep your eyes open. Try and slow your heart rate right down. Take a deep breath in, and off you go. Stay with the sound of my voice. I'm coming with you. How are you feeling?
I feel okay. Yeah, I think I'm okay. Where are we?
I don't think this has a name yet. Where do you want to be?
Home.
Then that's where we are.
I don't remember it looking like this.
This is just the beginning. It'll all make sense soon. Follow me. It's okay, Leo. I'm still here. I haven't gone anywhere.
Where? I can't see you.
I'm still sat beside you. It just feels like you're elsewhere.
You were right next to me in the foyer. I followed you.
I can't see what you're seeing. Remember, Leo? This is all your creation. It'll wear off. Just give it a second.
So this is where my mind chose to come. What is it you are trying to tell me?
Calm down, Leo. Don't fill your mind with more questions. Just wait until you find the trail. The answers will follow. What's next, Leon?
I'm sorry to snoop.
Oh, don't apologize. These are your memories as much as they're mine.
I don't recognize you.
Well, your mind can't invent faces on its own. You must have seen me somewhere before. An old boss? A teacher?
No.
Your mother?
No, I don't know my mother.
Well then, this could be her, couldn't it? Come on, Leo. You have to be more open-minded for this to work. Don't you want to know what she looks like? Just imagine.
I don't want to imagine.
You can't remember this house. Your toys. These memories. Your mind hasn't just erased her death, but her whole existence. You must remember the woods. Where are we now, Leo?
Just see trees everywhere. Should I recognize it?
Don't waste your energy. It'll come to you. Try using the rest of your senses.
Smell burning.
Can you see a fire? Any smoke? Concentrate, Leo. Do you see a car?
How did you know?
I hear an alarm.
It's just the machine. It's focusing on the memory. We're where we need to be. Do you remember what happened here? She was kidnapped when you were young, Leo. Can you remember finding her?
Why are you showing me this?
We've been here before, Leo. We need to work through it. You can't just push things into the corner of your mind. They'll fester and rot. Breathe, Leo. It feels so much better when we know the truth. Like a weight lifted. Stay with us, Leo. You need to face this. Leo? Leo, are you still with us? Leo? Leo, are you still there?
Hi.
Who are you? You weren't here before.
I've always been here.
I'm looking for someone. My mum. I think she's lost in here.
Sounds like you're the one who's lost. I haven't seen anyone else.
She didn't come home one night and we were waiting in the dark for hours. Then I was walking through the forest and then I saw a car up ahead.
Are you sure you're remembering it clearly this time? Every time you recall a memory, it's reconstructed slightly differently than overwritten. So when you try to recall it again, you're just remembering it the way you did last time, not the first time.
No, no, you're distracting me. You're doing it on purpose.
Do you know how long you've been coming here? To this forest? Every month for I don't know how long. For therapy? With Dr. Michelle? You really trust her, don't you? But you've never found what you're searching for.
No, she's trying to help me. It's slowly coming back. I remember the living room. I do, the aquarium. And I remember walking through the forest, and that's when I saw a car back.
Oh, why do you keep torturing yourself over these details? How do you even know Dr. Michelle's telling you the truth? How do you know she didn't implant the memory? You're accepting this way too quickly. Sorry. It's fine if you want to go on a wild goose chase again. It's never been my place to stop you.
You'll be all right. I'm tired. It feels better when I don't think.
Make new memories. Fill your mind with something else. Aren't you going somewhere?
What?
Thought you were in a hurry. Searching for something. Don't worry, I'm sure you'll remember it at some point. Then you'll be back here again. My car's up there. Do you want to go for a drive? These woods give me the creeps.
What are you listening to? You're so weird. Hey, I was kidding. Look, I really think you should just get your
mind
off of
it. You liked my abduction story, right?
Of course I did. I know you wanted this, but it's gonna be okay. This stuff is subjective. You know that. You're great.
Yeah, but my first choice basically said I suck.
Maybe you should take a break from writing. All it seems to be doing right now is hurting you. Look, and tonight is the perfect night to get your mind off things. Tonight, the concert, Greg. The Borgard concert, literally the only cool thing to happen in this town.
That's tonight. Look, Julia, I...
Sorry. I just... got a lot of things on my mind.
I'll be there.
Good. Be at my place by 9, okay? The concert starts at 11, but I refuse to be late. And bring your $40.
What was that?
What was what?
It's a big light.
Look, I didn't see anything.
Okay, you didn't see anything, then what's that? Wait. Was it a UFO? Whoa. That's weird.
Not weird.
Not you. I had a cut on my finger and now it's gone.
You're not lying?
Greg, by the way.
Stevie.
You're taking a lot of finger photos, Stevie.
Yep. That's what's great about digital.
So that thing? Was it a... like a...
But please keep your finger still. Look. I'm not entirely sure what it is, but I've seen it a bunch of times. By the way, you can call it a UFO. I mean, it's unidentified, and it is definitely flying. I'm crazy for saying it. I just had no idea that it had healing powers, if that's what's happening here. We can summon it if you want.
Hi, Greg, it's me, Julia, your girlfriend. You remember when I said 9 o'clock at my place? That was the thing. So now it's 9:15, I'm in front of your house, and you're not here either. You're probably writing right now, which is cool, but also we're supposed to be at a concert tonight. And regarding your strange final broadcast, no, I do not believe in UFOs. Not when everyone has a camera on their phone and no one seems to have videos of them anymore.
Starlight Symphony. I got the whole album on my iPod.
Your phone's off? Okay. First, I need you to set aside any skepticism you may have. One time I got bored, so I wrapped myself in speaker wire. The light stayed a lot longer.
You got bored, so you wrapped yourself in speaker wire.
Now, all you have to do is close your eyes, clear your mind, and think about them. Yes. Think about them.
I don't know who them are.
It's kind of hard to think when you keep disrupting me. Just, think about whatever it is you want them to be. Whatever that is. Just think about what you want.
Happen?
Yeah.
Do you ever feel weird about believing in this stuff? Thank you.
Hold on.
What was that?
Someone didn't think I wanted.
I've called you like a billion times. Forgot about the concert. Again. Who was that?
I'm Stevie.
No one's talking to you. Greg, are we okay?
Of course we're okay. I just... We're waiting for a UFO. Julia, I'm being serious. I was on my way to your house. And then I saw this light, and I don't really know how to explain it, but it just made me feel great. And then I met Stevie. This is Stevie. And he knows more about the lights, and so we went back to his house, and we summoned it. And all the lights just went crazy. And his device, it let us hear.
Well, the lights went crazy at my house, too. Don't point that thing at me!
Well, were you doing something to summon them?
No! No! No, 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 no. This is... crazy. This
yes.
is insane.
Yes, yes, this is insane.
Subscribe to Dust for new sci-fi every week.